Sir, I rise to support the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Amendment Bill 2015, which provides the provision to enhance the number of seats in Andhra Pradesh Legislative Council, sir, from 50 to 58. The Constitution provides the maximum number of seats to be given as 1/3 of the total number of seats in the Legislative Assembly of that state. Minimum number is prescribed to be 40. I am very happy to note that the Honorable Home Minister has brought this amendment bill to increase the number of seats in the council from 50 to 58, sir. Sir, all these things have occurred because of the hasty decision of the Congress by not going through in detail how to prepare the bill. Some things are in bill, some issues are outside the bill, in the form of the Prime Minister's assurance. Sir, Congress party leader has categorically pleaded for the benefits to be given to the state of Andhra Pradesh. I am very happy on that. But the same leader, while speaking on the budget, he opposes the industrial incentives given to the state of Andhra Pradesh in the name of the plight of capital and also in the name of inequality among the states. This is the double standard, sir. Honorable leader of the Congress party, president of the Congress party, pleaded for speedy execution of Polavaram project, sir. Prime Minister, the then Prime Minister, Manmohan Singh ji, promised on the floor of the House that all obstacles in the course of construction of Polavaram project will be removed and the ordinance will be given. That assurance was given by Honorable Prime Minister, then Prime Minister, by Manmohan Singh ji. That is being opposed by the Congress party MP Sukender Reddy ji. We support.
Please now address the chair.
We take care of
no mutual
rehabilitation, relief, operations, relief measures to be given to the Adivasis who are going to be displaced. We support fully for the R&R package for the tribal people who are going to lose their land. It should be taken up. Sir, my friend from TRS, they were saying that the 7 mandals were taken away by Andhra Pradesh. Sir, TRS is pleading from the beginning, we are not asking for a new state. Because the Telangana has come into being merged into Andhra Pradesh in 1956, whatever the area is being merged into Andhra Pradesh, we are simply asking for demerger. I am asking my friend, in 1953, where are these all 7 mandals? Is it in Telangana or is it in Andhra Pradesh? It is Bhadrachalam division, which is in East Godavari district. That is part of Andhra Pradesh. And we have not taken away the 7 mandals from Telangana. The Telangana Rashtra Samiti, whatever it has demanded, whichever is being merged into Andhra Pradesh, in 1956, only that part you have to ask for in Telangana. You cannot claim the districts, the area which is in Andhra Pradesh prior to 1956. That cannot be claimed by Telangana. Sir, I am calling the hasty decision of Congress in preparing this bill, Act, Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014. And Congress claims that we have given the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana states. They follow double standards in every respect. The very double standards practiced by the Congress has led to the result that has come in 2015 general election, sir. Sir, I would like to give a research topic for the political researchers. Sir, examine the democracy all over the world, in any other country, in any place. Sir, a party being in power for 10 years consecutively, contesting the next election, not getting even a single seat in the assembly and parliament. This type of democratic phenomena, can you see anywhere in the world? This is the research topic for the political pundits to ponder over how this type of situation can come. Therefore, I am not saying up and down, they can win or lose. I am trying to emphasize the position that a party in power for 10 years, immediately after the next election, not even getting deposits in the seats, I don't find it is not an ordinary situation. It is unprecedented, extraordinary political development that has occurred in Andhra Pradesh. I think now, even now, the Congress party can retrospect what they have done, what wrong they have committed, what mistake they have committed. Sir, in Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act, so many assurances were given for the people of Andhra Pradesh. Whether it is a revenue deficit, whether it is lack of educational institutions, whether it is river water issues,
please conclude.
I will conclude, sir. 2 minutes. Industrial development, backward area development, or the railway zone, Polavaram project, industrial incentives and all these things, assurances were given. I am very happy that the NDA government led by Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, have initiated action on every assurance given in the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014. And also on the assurances given by the then Prime Minister Manmohan Singh ji on the floor of the Rajya Sabha, sir. Definitely, I hope that our Honorable Prime Minister will pay much interest as far as the assurances of the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act are concerned. Definitely, Andhra Pradesh people are very confident, very assured that Narendra Modi ji will take care of the people of Andhra Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh state, sir. Lastly, I request the Honorable Home Minister to consider the number of increase of the assembly seats in Telangana and in Andhra Pradesh. If necessary, if the constitutional amendment is required, kindly take it up and see that the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana states will get the increased number of seats in the legislative assemblies as promised in the Act, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
So, you want to say something?